Often the pelvis is the most useful bone for determining a skeleton's biological sex. A narrow pelvis is beneficial for locomotion during upright walking. However, a wide pelvis is useful for childbirth. These conflicting demands are often termed the obstetrical dilemma. Let's explore these adaptations by examining the difference between the male and female pelvis. First and foremost, the male and female pelvis differ in shape. The male pelvis is higher and narrower than the female pelvis. You can see the iliac crest is much higher in the male pelvis. In the female pelvis, the distance between the anterior superior iliac spines is much greater, which makes the female pelvis shorter and wider. Second, the pelvic brims differ between the male and female pelvis. The pelvic brim is the superior edge of the pelvic inlet. In males, the pelvic brim is heart-shaped, and in females, it is oval. The broad, shallow pelvic brim and inlet of the female pelvis is adapted for the development and passage of a large-brained human infant. Next, the subpubic angles differ between the male and female pelvis. The subpubic angle is the angle created by the rami of the paired pubis and ischium bones and lies inferior to the pubic symphysis. In males, the angle is acute, less than 80 degrees, and in females, the angle is obtuse, greater than 90 degrees. The obtuse angle of the female subpubic angle increases the diameter of the pelvic outlet. The ischial tuberosities also differ. The ischial tuberosities are the paired, rounded rami of the ischial bones and mark the lateral boundary of the pelvic outlet. In males, the ischial tuberosities are closer together and projected downward. In females, they are farther apart and projected outward. The obturator foramina also differ between the male and female pelvis. The obturator foramina are those large openings, and because the male pelvis is taller and more narrow than the female pelvis, the obturator foramina of the male pelvis are rounder than the ones of the female, which are oval. Another difference between the male and female pelvis are the acetabula. The acetabula are the deep pockets that receive the head of the femur. In males, the acetabula are larger and closer together. In females, the acetabula are smaller and farther apart. The last two differences pertain to the vertebrae. The male sacrum is long, narrow, straighter, and has a pronounced sacral promontory. The female sacrum is shorter, wider, and more curved posteriorly and has a less pronounced promontory. Lastly, the coccyx in the male pelvis is projected inwards and immovable, while the coccyx of a female pelvis is straighter and more flexible. As you can see in this short video, the human pelvis has evolved for both the optimization of bipedal locomotion as well as a maximum width for childbirth in females.